It is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Priya Menon, who will speak about the troubleshooting of echocardiography in the ICU.
You have to let me in.
Most welcome, madam.
Hi.
Question can, yeah.
So I start. So very good evening to all. Thanking Dr. Muralidhar again. It's been more than a decade, our association, and I hope it goes long. So troubleshooting with echo in ICU. Why do we really need echo? Why can't we do something else? Because it's something which is immediately available to us. We have echo machines everywhere, portable, prevents delay in diagnosis, a very powerful imaging tool, and radiation and such problems are not there. We have different types of intensive care. You have medicine, intensive station, cardiological, neurological, pediatric. Today, in my talk, I'm going to stick to cardiological and our post-cardiac surgical intensive station. So what are the indications? Indications are acute, we all know, right? So the patient has a hemodynamic instability and we need to know, and so we get an echo. What can be the reasons for hemodynamic instability? You have plenty and more. Say patient has a pump failure, he has got a regional malvolution abnormality, or he has got a valvular abnormality, a sudden new onset of some MR or AR, or he had a prosthetic valve and now comes in with some stenosis or regurgitation, or the patient has had some limb surgery or something and suddenly becomes dyspneic, so you think, okay, there may be some pulmonary embolism, or post-CABG at midnight, the patient deteriorates and there is an effusion, or the patient comes suddenly with an aortic dissection. And these days, we have ventricular assist devices. So these are the indications what you have mostly in the ICU. So let's start one by one. So here you see everybody, I think till now you people know what dissection is and how it is. So this is ascending aorta dissection, right? A dissection in the thoracic aorta because of a penetrating ulcer. Dissection in the aortic arch. And dissection on the descending thoracic. So these pictures are so easy to obtain, but we get a direct diagnosis. You know, you don't need to do more. So let's see here. This is a very young lady, 28-year trainee, who lands into our ICU. She's 36 weeks pregnant, and she has a sudden onset of chest pain, and that pain is going to her back. And the pain is extremely severe, and it is not relieved by anything. She doesn't have any other problems. She doesn't have any vaginal bleeding or anything. And she had just a mild hypertension during her third trimester of pregnancy. No other history, no negative history for family. And now we look at her. Her hemodynamics look quite stable. Yeah. And we auscultation also. We don't hear any murmur, nothing. Fetus looks okay. The only thing what we saw was there were no palpable pedal pulses. So here, now should I go and do a transthoracic or should I go and do a transesophageal echo? So obviously we thought better we do a transesophageal echo. And so what do we see? This is the four chamber view. Looks okay. Explain. That also looks okay. And there comes, we do all the views of the aorta. And what do we see? See, very surprisingly, there is an AR, but we could not hear any murmur. So this was our diagnosis. So we called up the obstetricians. We called up the cardiovascular team. Patient shifted to the OR, did a LSCS with a mechanical ventral, and then we followed up the patient, the baby and the mother. They both were doing fine. So this was because of a TEE. Now, there is another gentleman here in the cardiological ICU who comes with the chest pain, which is radiating to the back. ECG is normal, enzymes are normal, transthoracic echo is normal. So we go ahead, do an echo, and what do we see here? We see an intramural hematoma. And you know, an intramural hematoma, you treat exactly like dissection. So that was also a diagnosis in the ICU. Now, these days we have, the previous speakers have already spoken about VADs. So you know about the different generations of VADs and the problems with VADs. So let's see how in ICU the VAD behaves. So here there's a person, 56-year-old, who had a HeartMate 2 as a bridge to cardiac transplantation done almost an year back. Yeah, in between now, he had some bleeding from the nose, and so his anticoagulation was tapered. Now, suddenly he comes with fatigue, dark urine, and ictric sclera, totally yellow.
Will we be able to fix the connection, I hope, soon?
Yeah.
Priya, can you hear us?
She's freezed.
Priya Menon? Priya Menon, can you see us?
I think there is a disconnection from Dr. Priya's end.
Yeah.